to the government official, to the Cambodian students to study English. And also I would like to thank the Australian Embassy, but also the US Embassy for supporting the Cambodian English teacher. As you all know, we adopted the new curriculum to teach foreign languages from grade 4. So in primary school, for grade 4, 5, 6, the students are required either to learn English or to learn French. But it is very difficult for me to encourage students to learn French because it's very hard to find French language teacher and hard to encourage the student to learn French. Overall, there are only 3,000 Cambodian students studying French as a first language and more than 400,000 as a second language. But more than 2 million of Cambodian students study English as either first or second language. The reason why there are many students who can study English is that we have many programs supported, including today that we have around 1,000 Cambodian teachers supported to attend this conference. Therefore, I would like to thank the Australian and US Embassy for supporting them, and also would thank IDP for making the application possible to learn from their peers how to teach English as a foreign language. I'm also very grateful to this call for providing opportunity to Cambodian students living in the rural villages to learn English. So we decided to post the volunteers in the teacher training center where the teachers of primary school who teach all the subjects, Khmer, language, mathematics, social studies, and English, who can teach English even from grade 4. Usually, the school principal allocated the young teacher who speaks English to teach from grade 4, 5, 6, because he or she can teach math, Khmer, language, but also English at the same time. While the teacher who don't speak English would teach from grade 1 to 3. Therefore, in many of the Cambodian schools, even in the remote area, in the village, we can implement the curriculum because the teacher who gone through the teacher in the center in which he or she studied English can teach basic English, and we have the textbook that localized in the Cambodian context so that it is more relevant to teach English to the Cambodian student. From grade 7 to grade 12, we have specialized teacher who teach only English as a subject in middle high school and also in senior high school. English prepares the student well for the education because many students aspire to have high education. High education will give them job, decent work. Without education, they cannot get a decent job. Therefore, English is not just a medium of communication, but English helps the student to get high education, to get job, to get knowledge. But also we are living in a more globalized world. The students are not required just to learn one language. And research shows that bilingual children can have more intelligence, and the brain also can be developed with the efforts made by the children who speak not just one language, but two or more languages. Therefore, in a more globalized world, learning languages, English, but also other languages, also very important. Therefore, from grade 7 onward, we require the student to study English or French as the first language, and then they can choose another second language. In the digital area, I think also for the teacher to learn is also very important. ICT can play a very important role in the English language training. More importantly, the application used in smartphone can help to improve English language skills for the teacher and to create the professional learning communities in which the teacher can share their expertise, their experiences, and their best practices in teaching foreign languages, especially in English. That's why I'm very happy that this year theme, this year conference theme is teaching English in the digital area. Education must respond to the needs of society. Education must respond to the needs of the economy. Education must respond to the needs of the world. And we are living in a very challenging world. We must give our young people the skill set needed to thrive in the digital economy. Therefore, I would like to thank all of you for agreeing to come here to Cambodia to share